If you say that the central government is waiting for the whole term to be over, the whole session to be over, then I would like to remind you the story of the Tiger Clause and Shivaji.
You defeated
a person who is working for the poor people
like
is never liked by the bourgeois class.
The Bagnakha.
A person who has come up from the poor class, struggling masses, is never liked by the bourgeois class.
Let's get the other panelists. Arnosh Singh Bal. Arnosh Singh Bal.
But as long as the people of West Bengal are
Ma'am, the question is the person in Kolkata not the Aam Aadmi? Ravi Shankar Prasad, welcome to the show. The question was put to a representative of the Trinamool Congress. Is the person in Kolkata who is going to have to pay almost 15% more for electricity as per an order of the West Bengal State Electricity Regulatory Commission not an Aam Aadmi? So you have one policy. You discover the Aam Aadmi when it comes to putting pressure.
When it comes to putting pressure
on the central government, you forget the Aam Aadmi in Kolkata.
Only about 12%.
Mr. Prasad, what do you think?
And that is also because...
Mr. Prasad, no, 15%. 15%.
Our commitment,
ma'am, railway fares have been also hiked by 15% on an average.
Fare hike, this amount of price hike in petroleum products.
One sec, let's give the other panelists in. Ravi Shankar Prasad, what do you think?
That is our objection.
Ravi Shankar Prasad, what do you think?
Well, Arnav, as far as this hike part is concerned, that is only one aspect of it. What concerns me all the more is the complete paralysis which the UPA government is suffering. Almost becoming a laughing stock, stumbling from one and almost critical situation to another. The Prime Minister not in a position to understand as to how to handle it. Pranab Babu making desperate calls. I understand there are compulsions in coalition government. They will be there. But the larger question is the same. Mamta ji was also a part of NDA. She left it in 2003. I had the honor to be a minister in Bajpayee government working there. And many of the reform initiatives, including containment of price, etc., the whole highway program in the Electricity Act of 2003, all was passed by taking her on board. Yesterday, you may recall in the Raj Sabha, the DMK walked into the well of the house on the issue of discrimination of Tamil people in Sri Lanka. Therefore, allies are not being taken on board. For the last 2 years, there has been no meeting of the Congress with their allies on many critical issues. Therefore, these are only symptoms what is happening.
Mr. Prasad. Mr. Prasad.
Yes.
You're avoiding the issue also. You're also avoiding the issue because you are leaving the option open of working with the Trinamool in the future. My question to you, sir, with all respect, Mr. Prasad, is very direct. Do you believe that economic rationale should be the deciding factor in running a ministry like the railways? Should it run on economic logic?
The reply
or should it run on political logic?
The reply is very simple.
Simple question.
The reply is very simple, Arnav. You may not like it, but in a democratic country like India, one is what is economically desirable, and the second is what is politically feasible. And what is important from the political leader having authority, not like the present Prime Minister, is to ensure that there is a proper blend of the two. That is very important. You stressed the ball.
I am still asking. No, please.
I think tomorrow we are going to meet on the budget issue. We'll have long discussion on that.
But you asked me a question straight away. Absolutely.
Let me ask you a political question, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad.
Yes.
Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, yes. The political question to you is, are you accepting the hike in railway fares but only finding fault with the way UPA is handling its allies?
That's the question.
Is this your objective to put the Congress party on the mat?
We have also flagged our concern as far as hike part is concerned. We will elaborate that once the railway budget debate starts, Navika. Our representative will do it very elaborately. But certainly one question I am willing to ask, how is it that 2-3 years ago, a great politician from my own state who was railway minister was being given certificate by the management institutes world over as having brought about a great revolution in the railway under the UPA dispensation. Surplus budget, no hike, lot of revenue generation. Therefore, the fact and the truth was being concealed. Is it a fact or not? Come on, be very honest about it. Therefore, the entire issue has to be seen in the totality of it.
I take your point. Mr. Prasad, you are saying that you have an experience of managing Mamata Banerjee better. I give you full marks for it. I don't completely agree with you on it because I have some experience of what has happened in the NDA, you know, with Jayalalitha and Mamata Banerjee. So do you, but you are looking at the glass as half full. I am looking at it as half empty. That's fine. Hartosh Singhbal, so sorry to come to you late. Do you think tonight Kakoli Ghosh Dastidar gave a clear answer to my straight question? Are the people of Kolkata who will have to pay 15% more for their electricity not the Aam Aadmi for Mamata Banerjee? Isn't that the question Mamata Banerjee must answer? She allows the electricity hike of 15% in her own state.
It's only 12%.
No, I'm not... Ma'am, you are now going by what, 12% or 15%? Hartosh.
Arnab, let me come in. I think the basic issue you are talking about, if we are so bothered about the Aam Aadmi, let's look at this rail budget and the hike that you are focusing on. If you look at the base year of 2007 and Mr. Lalu Prasad's tenure that Ravi Shankar Prasad was referring to, from then on, under Mamata Banerjee and then followed by Dinesh Trivedi, there have been 50 to 60 extra deaths every year in rail accidents. People dying in rail accidents, people exposed due to safety considerations are also Aam Aadmi. And not to look at that fact, to wish that away and make this debate entirely about economic rationale is to do injustice to the Aam Aadmi.
Yeah.
Some of this hike is necessary, and it is necessary because the Aam Aadmi must be safe when he travels on the railways.
Absolutely.
Who is going to answer
this? But this is not about the Aam Aadmi. My contention is, Hartosh, that the Aam Aadmi is being used. The Aam Aadmi argument is being used whenever you feel like. Mamata Banerjee doesn't remember the Aam Aadmi of Kolkata. She remembers the Aam Aadmi when it comes to the railway budget. Isn't that the real issue here, Navika?
Absolutely. You know, we must throw that's the real issue. And the question to Ms. Dastidar is very clear. Ms. Dastidar, what is the ultimatum that the Trinamool Congress is giving the Congress party? How long will you wait till the Prime Minister actually removes Dinesh Trivedi from his position as Railways Minister, as has been made clear by your party?
Yeah,
I'll come to that. But you see, you have just been misleading the viewers that, you know, Honorable Chief Minister of West Bengal is not bothered about the Aam Aadmi. We don't call it Aam Aadmi. We call it the common man, the common poor people. In Bengal, she is only bothered about this and the hype. That is not true. You should see to the agenda in the state. And we are not going to increase any fare, we are not going to increase any kind of price. We never support the petroleum product price hike. We have shown our way. We do not support foreign direct investment. So it is not only that she
is
not bothered about the
state.
And even in the state, she has stood by the kisan, by the common farmer, by the mazdoor who works in the field, the khet mazdoor we called it. And she has fasted for 26 days trying to save farmland and you know, multi-crop agricultural land in Singhur when it was being sold off at 1 rupee.
So
she is in the common land everywhere and she will fight for the common land.
Let me ask a different question.
One second.
The agenda is for the common poor people and the party does not believe in taxing first.
Let me ask a simple question.
Who live with an earning of
let me ask a simple question.
We do not want to tax these people of India where 60% of women of the reproductive age suffer from anemia. We do not want to tax these people of India who lose 16,000 children every day. We do not want to tax these poor people of India who do not get two square meals a day. There is no electricity. There is no infrastructure for village roads. We do not want to tax. That is our party stand. And if Mamata Banerjee is following it up, she is doing it throughout the country. Not only. She is trying to disrupt the central government. That is the major issue that we want to highlight.
Let me ask you.
One minute. We are getting two questions here. 1 minute. Sankarshan. My question is, before Sankarshan has raised this and I'll come to him.
If I may.
Yes, Sankarshan.
Why does the Trinamool Congress continue to be an ally of this government and a part of this government?
Simple question. Yeah, why are you still with the government? Why are you still with the government? What's your compulsion to be with the government?
That is our prerogative. That is what we want to decide. The Congress is the secular force and we want to be with
them. So how long will you decide in?
Being part of this government is not your prerogative.
How long will you give the government time
to
remove the
prerogative? in every family, in every individual's family, in all of your families, in my family,
if you are calling this a family, then this is certainly a very unhappy family.
Let me ask a question.
Is very important. Let me ask a question. And the regional parties have their regional commitment.
Let me ask a question.
The centre does not understand completely.
Let me ask a question.
Their regional commitment.
1 minute. Lord Meghnad Desai is asking you a question.
Don't try to hurt our proportion. And don't try to disturb
Meghnad Desai asking a question. After that, Ravi Shankar Prasad, I'm coming to you. Yes.
Let me ask you. You boast that you're not going to tax anybody in West Bengal. All that happens, you pile up a big debt and then you come to central government and say, bail us out. Okay. So you may protect West Bengal, but the rest of India is paying. Because that money comes out of taxation, which all the Aam Aadmi is also paying. So you are saying in West Bengal we want to have no price increases, so the rest of India can pay because we just pile up the debt and be part of the debt and be part of the debt. What kind of policy is that to protect the poor?
Just button here. You know, the Trinamool Congress seems to pretend as if the poor exist only in West Bengal.
Exactly.
They exist all over the country. Yeah. A. B. If you talk to any poor person today, he sympathizes and empathizes with the small rise. And I think if you did a nationwide opinion poll.
I think if you did an opinion poll,
90% of people will back this.
Absolutely.
You have been talking to the city people and the city dwellers.